March 20th, 2017, Cameron City Council, not the order. You all stand and join in the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next item on the agenda, roll call, please.
Darlene Breckenridge, here. Dennis M. Clark.
Here.
Jerry Ann Evans.
Here.
John R. Hyder.
Here.
Ronnie Jack.
Here.
That takes us to the minutes of the March 6th, 2017, regular session. There are no additions or corrections.
So moved. Sorry.
Move to the second discussion. See if there is none, we'll proceed to vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Five in favor, zero opposed. Next item on the agenda is public participation. Individuals addressing the council or as a step to the microphone, clearly state your name and address before speaking. You have a 5-minute time limit. There's also a piece of paper up there if you can put your name and address on it. There will be a...
Hi, my name is Gina Reed. I'm from 324 East Fifth Street in Cameron. And I'm here to report about the weekend's events, the Irish Fest, which was sponsored by several different organizations this year. It's actually probably the first ones I know of. That I don't know if we've had any collaborations, although we have a lot of Irish heritage here and there have been a lot of events. And I want to say that everything went well. The Colleen Dover and Kelly Works concert was sponsored by the Cameron Municipal Band. The Jazz Q was sponsored by the, I believe, the Band Boosters and the Music Boosters Club to raise funds for the Disney trip, which will be taken this spring. The Dustin Wilkes Country Western concert was sponsored by Warrior Outdoors, and the Vendor Fair was sponsored by the Historic Preservation Society at the Old School. And I think that the success of these events is due to people working together. And I don't think that it's a problem we have too many stacked events in Cameron. I think that we do have a lot of events that can has had the potential to bring a lot of people to town. I had lots of happy reports from all of the concerts, everybody that went. The vendors were not especially happy with the crowd that they attended, but they understood that retail is hard in March, and so they are looking forward to coming back and staying with us. And the Old School would like to have another vendor fair in November so that they can come back. And we want to work with these small business owners and to help improve their business, which their business will improve our life here in Cameron. We had over 30 vendors that are the Irish Fest vendor fair. And frankly, I don't think we have 30 business buildings that would hold that many retailers at the time. So it's kind of nice to have this pop-up mall sort of thing. And that's what I really want to come to you and talk about, is because I feel like this is economic development at the grassroots level. And I think that a lot of people have been doing a lot of work for economic development without compensation as I have, because we have a lot of love for our community. And you know, I say this everywhere I go because I'm very proud that my family had a large part in the filming of Cameron. And so I want to see that continue, and I want to see this area grow, and I want to see the things that we can do as individuals. And I would like to see the city of Cameron continue efforts with economic development the way they're doing with large, you know, as it was reported in the newspaper last week with Terry Irmerings along. But I would also like you to consider very seriously the small efforts that are made that can really add up. So that's all I have to say, and I do hope that you will be in attendance at the next events. There's one on May 14th for Mother's Day. It's foods and wine. The Harlemans will be coming from Kansas City. We're intending to have, Culinary Arts Council will be intending to have another artist festival this year around June before the 4th of July. And we'll be looking forward to the old school having, hosting lots and lots of events because they are really great things in that building. So thank you very much for your time, and I hope that you will seriously consider doing some funding or encouraging or even going to concerts or just meeting people that are here to make things better in Cameron.
Thank you. Anyone else wishing to speak? Seeing there is none, that leads to the city manager's report.
The first item on my report is a website that was announced by the Missouri Partnership that will help market economic development sites around the state that cities have to offer or communities have to offer. And our 46-acre site, since it is already a certified site, which we had to go through a long process to get that done, now that it has been done, it will be on that website. So there'll be a flyover video that will show prospective people in a short, video of what they would be getting. So it'll cut down a lot of time on people on these search firms doing this work. So it'll be a nice thing, I think. And then the any other sites would get certified, then they would qualify for that as well. On our construction projects, Grove Street, nothing really new to report on that. The project's proceeding, however, working on easement portions right now. The pedestrian bridge for the trail, Bartlett West, is design work pretty much complete there. Industrial Park investigation, had that meeting March 15th in work session, and Bartlett West made that presentation to council, so we'll keep moving on that. The sewer plant project, wastewater plant's continuing, nothing major at this time, it's near completion. Animal shelter. Architects are finishing up the design phase of the project right now. We'll need to make a final decision on location real soon. Head Start facilities, same way, project's going as planned. No hiccups in it. It's just getting the going through the process and paperwork right now. Development projects. We have several potential development projects here recently that are in preliminary stages. So. Looking good. We've got several interests from several different entities. So what will actually materialize, we don't know yet, but we know the current work at the Chums area up there at the ship, at the Wendy's, that parking lot area and all that is proceeding, and it's going to be a big expansion to the parking area, and then they'll be adding a 7,000 square foot building to that for some sort of restaurant. The Nails truck stop area is should be under construction any time and haven't started yet, so they should be ready to go pretty soon. That's all I have.
Questions, comments, Mark? Seeing there is none, we go to unfinished business. We have a second final reading of Bill 2017-6.
Bill 2017-6, an ordinance calling a special election in the city of Cameron, Clinton and DeKalb counties, Missouri, on the question whether a city shall impose a local use tax on out-of-state purchases at a rate equal to the rate of the local sales tax in effect in the city. The title on this was prepared before the annexation, so it will be amended to say Cameron, Clinton, DeKalb, and Caldwell counties.
I'll entertain a motion to pass Bill 2017-6 on a second reading.
So moved. Second.
Moved and second. We have discussion.
I've got just a thought on this particular tax. So my understanding is at this point we're not getting any sort of a sales tax from the internet. I'm thinking maybe it's time to go ahead and I'll put my hand out there across the aisle, and I will vote for this measure as long as we include language that is included that this will be used for the police department exclusively, and that the city will not remove any funds from the general fund that's normally provided to the police force. If at any time, other than just normal decreases that are caused by whatever reason, whether downturn in the economy or whatever, if it's ever done other than that reason, that we would rescind this tax. I've just got to be honest with you, we need to start being more transparent, I believe, in all regards. So if it's going to be used for something like that, I'm fine with it. But we've got water rates that are going to continue to increase, and we're going to have land that we recently purchased as well. We're going to have a tax to continue to develop. So I just want to throw it out there. I think this is the way that we could do it. And I'll extend the olive branch.
Question, maybe more of a comment, but it's my understanding that Amazon currently already collects this tax?
One thing I read from MML said it was January 7th of 17 that they were to collect it, and then recently read something said November. So I'm not sure if they've started yet or not, but they will be. And all the cities that don't have a use tax will not get the
tax that citizens are going to pay, but the parent will still be paying.
If they will be collecting and paying, remitting state tax at the state tax rate of the 4.225%. And then the cities that have the use tax, that will be submitted. Amazon will need to pay that additional 2.5% or whatever it is on those orders as well. That's the way I understand it right now. It's about $30,000, $29,000 to $33,000 is the estimate from MML.
And then just further into this comment, it will all come in a lump sum. It won't be a separate line item to even be able to know what was in it for just sales or not.
I don't know how that'll be broken down. It can't be broken down like the other businesses. So
let me get this straight. The state will get
225,
and then we would be an additional 2 point something on top of that.
Right, and then the counties would, whatever they do, would be as well. So
any further questions? Shall we proceed to vote? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Nay.
I'll entertain a motion to pass bill 2017-6 on third reading by roll call.
So moved. Second.
Moved and seconded. Discussion?
Darlene Breckenridge?
No.
Dennis M. Clark?
Yes.
Jerry Ann Evans?
Yes.
John R. Piper?
No.
Ronnie Jack?
Yes.
Next item on the agenda, we have a budget rate discussion.
Mayor, I think I have an opportunity to review the information.
I have, and I actually have some questions.
Do you want to review the material first, or do you want
to? I'd like to review first. We can discuss it, but I still have some questions to go over. Anybody else have anything?
I'm going to be table it until we have an opportunity to look at it.
That is table for now. Proceed to vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Aye in favor, zero opposed. Takes us to new business. We have a first reading on Bill 2017-7.
Bill 2017-7, an ordinance for the City of Cameron, Clinton, DeKalb, and Caldwell Counties to serve, authorizing a conditional use permit for David Roth, allowing an indoor archery range and retail sales at 1117 Ryan Road.
I'll entertain a motion to pass Bill 2017-7 on first reading.
So moved.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Discussion?
Go ahead, Paul.
It is re-
process about probably 2-3 years I've been looking at this. Mm-hmm. So finally pulled the trigger and created that piece.
Any questions? We'll proceed to vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Aye in favor, zero opposed. Next item, we have a full reading on Bill 2017-8.
Bill 2017-8, an ordinance authorizing the City of Cameron and County staff to write off uncollectible utility accounts at City of Cameron, Clinton, DeKalb, and Caldwell Counties, Missouri.
I will entertain a motion to pass Bill 2017-8 on first reading.
So moved. Second.
Moved and seconded. Discussion.
Ms. Mayor, what you have before you is a ordinance to annual write-off ordinance for our uncollected utility accounts. Back in 2005, the city instituted an annual write-off policy. So each year we do write off those accounts that are more than 3 years old. This year we're looking at about $25,000. That's actually about $9,000 less than last year and about $20,000 less than 2015. So our efforts in-house to kind of collect this money seem to be yielding some results. So I think we're kind of moving in the right direction there. In the future, some things we might consider to kind of help combat this would be possibly looking about raising our utility deposit. What would require for the deposit might be some way to kind of to offset this. But for the most part, the $25,000 for a city of our size, I think we're good.
Can I, before you get out there, is it, I guess, we can ask the attorney, but would it be legal for us to post these names in the newspaper and just, or do we already do this? I'm just curious because sometimes maybe they just don't know. I mean, phone numbers change, whatever. But also because the rest of the community is paying for these phones.
Sure.
If they're not paying.
I'm going to do a little bit of research on that just so I can
okay.
100% sound of posting people's names because it can be viewed poorly by some. You know.
I'm not
viewed back and over.
I just want to make sure this is legal.
Yeah, that's what.
That's my
view. Yeah.
real quick, another thing for you. And I know we talked about this last year, but I did go out and look at NCIS Collections, Municipal Collection Service. They stated that there would be no cost for us to do a collections effort with them if we provide them the information. I'm sure they don't, it may be 50-50, it may be 70-30,
right.
But anything at this point, if we're gonna go ahead and write them off and then provide them, then it's just more money that we can keep ourselves, potentially rather than just
yeah, I know the city has worked with a collections agency in the past, and I don't think
it's in charge.
Sure, right. Right.
They're not going to recover all of their accounts. There's no way to recover.
Right, and that's the point, though. But they're charging nothing, so whatever they bring in $10 or $5 if they're split in half and half, that we get on $25,000. I saw two names on here that I knew that had just moved, so I'm wondering. You know, right. In a situation where, hey, just call them up and.
You said NCIS?
Yeah, if you want, you can just have this. I've got the, just the information right at the top of that. I'm not guaranteeing anything, but it's just another way to.
It's definitely worth looking into.
See if we can do it. And if we can't, I completely understand and I'm fine with it. I don't want to be spending money chasing.
Right.
Chasing this money, but if we can get some of that at no cost,
sure,
we go for it.
Yeah, possibly we'll definitely check in.
Thank you.
We'll proceed to vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Aye in favor, zero opposed. I'll entertain a motion to suspend the rules and pass Bill 2017-8 on the second reading.
So moved. Yeah.
Move and second. Discussion.
Well, if we actually, I mean, if he can actually find out something before the next meeting, if that could check into that, that's why I just wanted to make sure, see how it should be done. That would be my other question. Zach, do you think you'd have time before the next meeting to just give them a call, just see if that's something that we could do over there and see, do we need to keep these on the books or?
Yeah.
Kendra?
Yeah.
I would appreciate that.
Yeah.
You'd have to rescind the motion and then you have a motion to table. Then you'd have to rescind his motion.
Sure, I'll rescind.
On the second.
Rescind the second.
Yeah, rescind the second.
And then you make a motion.
I make a motion that we wait until we hear back from Zach at the next meeting.
I'll move.
Second.
And motion is given. Next item on the agenda is first reading on bill 2017-9, which you have removed from the agenda. And it will be on the next meeting. So that takes us to our second public presentation. Individuals addressing council are asked to set up a microphone to clearly state your name and address to proceedings in a private statement. Either is none. Takes us to Ms. Lane's part.
I don't know if you all had time to look through this, but kudos to the newspaper because this is a very, very nice publication and got all the wonderful things that's going on in here. And I hope everybody gets a chance to read it. There's some copies over there on the chair if anybody in the audience would like it, or if they're all gone, I'll make sure you get one.
And there's free copies of the newspaper.
And free copies of the newspaper.
John?
At this time, I don't have anything.
Danny?
I'm good.
Dennis Hansard.
Yes.
Jeremy Evans.
Yes.
John R. Piper.
Yes.
Ron Jack.